Have you ever heard someone use the term balls out? Well, it doesn't mean what you think it does. To learn where the term balls out originated, we must go back to the year 1788, when Scottish inventor and mechanical engineer James Watt was looking for a way to automatically regulate the speed of a steam engine. He stumbled on a mechanism known as a flyball or centrifugal governor, which had been used in windmills for nearly a century, regulating the distance and pressure between the millstones. Watt saw this as the perfect solution and adapted the device to control the speed of his steam engine.
Aha!
Here's how he got the ball rolling, or spinning as it were. The output shaft of Watt's steam engine powers the spindle of the governor. Two weighted balls are attached to it with swing arms. As the engine turns faster, centrifugal force causes the balls to spin and lift outward. The swing arms are connected to a lever to engage the throttle valve, decreasing the amount of steam going into the engine cylinder, thus regulating the speed of the engine automatically. So, when an engine is running at full speed, the balls are out. Hence, the meaning of the term balls out is not as salty as you think it is. So not only did Watt's adaptation of the flyball governor give us one of the most misused terms today,
you're welcome.
He also created a very primitive version of a closed-loop control system, much like a modern closed-loop control system we might see in manufacturing today. For example, when we want to control the temperature of media in a process, we'd use a sensor to measure the temperature, a controller to gauge the level of error between the sensor reading and the controller's set point. Then the controller engages an actuator, in this case a heater, to bring the temperature up, or a heat exchange to bring it down. Compare that to Watt's flyball governor, and you've got the spindle sensing the speed of the engine, with the flyballs reacting to the increased speed, and like a controller, engaging the throttle valve, which in this case is the actuator, reducing the amount of steam going to the cylinders, thus bringing the speed of the engine back into a safe range. And there you have it. The more things change, the more they stay the same. Need help with your process? Contact one of our engineering experts at Omega.com. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe.